Everyone, welcome back to Super Auto Pets, and this game, we're going and we're talking about everyone's favorite new pet, the new tier 6 pet, the Leviathan. I can't speak. The Leviathan is, I think, like, one of the worst tier 6s in the game. Like, I think it's horrible. It has one ability, and that ability is, at the end of the turn, at level 1, it spawns 4 10-10 fish. At level 2, it spawns 4 20-20 fish. And at level 3, it spawns 4 30-30 fish. And obviously, the problem with this is that in order to maximize the Leviathan use, your team can only be the Leviathan at the end of the turn. It's not like on feint, it summons them. It's end of turn. So you have to sacrifice your entire team to try to get the Leviathan to a victory, which is, it's stupid. I hate it. It's dumb. So obviously, because you have to rely on one pet to get you a win, we're trying to win as fast as possible. Like, I have to set up to get a Leviathan to level 3, and pivot to him, and continually win. So it's a little bit of a challenge, I'm going to be honest. This run took a few attempts. So here we're going to go boom, Varghast, flip, and we're going to Ogopogo. So we're going to get the level up boost on the jelly, and we'll level up the Varghast. And yeah, just trying to get the most, the maximize my stats so I can get a win here. Luckily, the bird lives with one health, so we're able to clutch up, get a win there. That one was honestly pretty big. So boom, level up. Right into a Cyclops. That's exactly what you want to see in your tier 4 level up, because the Cyclops is a must-buy. We're going to move the Ogopogo to the front so we can keep leveling up the Ogopogo. And he's going to get some mana boost and some chocolate from the Cyclops. It's going to be great. And this still allows us to buffer Jellyfish a little bit. And we'll get a kill there, and then because of the weakness with our Varghast, the jellyfish can sweep our way, and we're just going to continue going here. Upgrade him. Upgrade. Like, we've got tons of upgrades getting planned. We're going to keep scaling the jelly now, because he's big. And our Ogopogo is going to level himself up to level 3 here. So he's still going to get mana boosted, stat boosted, all the boosts. Our guest solos the goose, and we're going to be able to take out giraffes and keep on rolling here. We're up to 4 wins. So you can see hatching chick is probably the key to this run, because right, we're scaling with our hatching chick. We're going to sell our Varghast to get a monkey, big stats. Because the Cyclops is going, he's going to stay around a little bit, obviously, just because of, we're going to need him for the Leviathan to get that dude leveled up. So, luckily, big hatching chick here is gonna just sweep its way across here, get a win there, and we're gonna have just enough health for a jellyfish to stay alive, even with the weakness, just because those pets weren't very strong in the back. We're gonna unfreeze the blobfish, not really room for him, and we're gonna keep changing the orientation here, another monkey. We've leveled up the Cyclops to level 2. That's huge. And once again, we're going to use the Varghast to level, or Ogopogo, to get himself to level 3. Boom, he just heals right back up after that. We trade there. We live here. Mosasaurus does nothing right now. And that's an easy win. We still have the jellyfish in the back. Don't ask why he's in the back. I don't have a good answer for you. We're going to freeze a chocolate. We're going to see what we get here. All the way down. I believe I'm not sure what I'm saving that chocolate for, honestly. Let's hope it doesn't matter. Also, we're scaling the Ogopogo, which is a little weird, but huge mana hit right there. Honestly, that's clutch. That saves us right there. Jelly's gonna win, and the rat is gonna give us the win. Why do you put a rat in the back? Don't ever do that. Terrible idea. We're gonna try to level up our hatching chick. Big upgrade there for our monkey. And there's a Leviathan, and we're gonna get him in immediately because we need to start scaling him. We're gonna put the hatching chick on, and it's see, there's the fish go. See, not very helpful. But we need to get this Leviathan scaled up as fast as possible. So we're double scaling it right now. And here we have a vampire bat team. Boo. You suck. Vampire bat's just the worst. It's not fun to play against. There's nothing fun about playing that. We lose, obviously. It's a vampire bat team. But there, boom. That is another huge thing there. Of getting the hatching chick to level 3. He can just start... leveling up our Leviathan to get him to level 3. So in 2 more turns, he's going to be level 3, and it's going to be massive. Once again, the monkey's still buffing him. So here we have Front Whale. Truly one of the strategies of our generation. Mana hit, we're going to sweep there. And our monkey's strong enough to do decent damage, get it to the jellyfish, get a win. And we are up to 8 wins on turn 12. Everything's starting to come together here. So right there, after this turn, we're going to be able to get our Leviathan to level 3 there. So that's big. Boom. He's level 3. That's what you want to see. Give him mana. Give him scaling. He's now 31-43. So we're going to keep going here. And big Minotaur doesn't matter. We have big fish man. Easy dub. Here we go, last round, and because we need the Leviathan to be by himself, we kill everyone else. Everyone's dead. And we now have 20 gold to just roll down and try to scale him up as much as possible. Eating those chicken legs. Give him a pair. I believe there's one more. Yeah, another chicken leg, huge. So he's now 42-50. We're gonna put him at the back so we get all the fish behind him so we can get that melon armor in the front. And here we go. This team seems fine to beat. It's the skunk, kinda scary, but we're big enough to take out 2 of their pets and the fish can do the rest. And boom, Leviathan basically by himself win. Absolute W, I'm the best at this game.